Ladyhawke. 50% lady, 50% hawk, 100% pop perfection. The rockstar Kiwi is a two-time ARIA winner, multi-instrumentalist, and can write a hook like no other. With COVID clipping her wings, she hasn't toured outside of NZ for 5 long years. But now the borders are open, she's broken out and burning up. In the country, as part of her rescheduled Time Flies tour, Ladyhawke's playing near you and she's ready to swoop.
Would you please welcome Ladyhawke? Great to see you. Great to see you back in Australia.
Yeah.
After COVID so rudely interrupted your touring plans, is it good to be back and ready to rock in front of Aussie fans?
Yeah, it's amazing. It's surreal because it was, you know, postponed and postponed and postponed, and I'm finally here. It's a bit surreal.
Your music has always had a sense of nostalgia to it for everyone, but for me personally, like I said off air, who are some of the creatives that have influenced your work?
There's so many people, like David Bowie, Courtney Love. I mean, a lot of them, you'll be like, Courtney Love? I don't hear that in your music, but it's like, these are people who inspired me to make music, you know? Nirvana, Kylie Minogue, like...
A real range.
Madonna. Yeah. Yeah. Just anyone who sort of inspired me to, like, write, really. Yeah.
But you don't just write. You provide these hooks. Your songs are so hooky. Mm. Is that just something that comes from within you? But all the artists you're describing there are very hooky as well.
Yeah, but... I was always drawn to a hook. Mm. And that's my favourite part about writing a song is, like, I always think, what would I like to sing along to, you know? Like, what's going to get stuck in my head, so...
So it becomes anthemic almost.
Yeah.
You're like the opposite of Peter Pan. He hates hook.
He does. Thanks, Tom.
It took a while, but we got there.
We enjoyed it. We really did.
Thanks.
We need to talk about something quite serious, though. Your latest album is called Time Flies, mm-hmm. but, you know, you wrote it after you had a pretty scary brush with cancer. Can you talk us through what happened there?
Yeah, I was... I had my daughter, she was at the time 10 months old, and so I was, you know, new mum, very tired, but sort of extra tired, and I went to the doctors and they discovered a melanoma on my leg, and it was malignant as well. It was a Clark's level 5 one, so it wasn't good. Mm. And I had to have surgery and, you know, lymph node removal and all that stuff, but I got given the all clear. So after all of that, there was a chunk of time where I had no idea what the future held for me.
Yeah.
And so I had to go through all these things in my head, and then all of a sudden I got given the all clear and I felt like nothing that I used to, like, toil over in my head mattered anymore, you know? So I had this whole new lease on life, and everything I do is for my daughter, you know? Yeah. And the music thing, I don't care as much anymore about, like, overthinking everything, and I just make what's fun, you know. I just want to make fun music, and
that must feel quite, like, liberating or freeing, right?
I
mean, it's quite a destructive process, but it seems like, listening to you, that there's a whole lot of beauty that's flourished out the other side.
Yeah, it's been, you know, it's been a few years of therapy, but yeah, it's like, it's something that I think, you know, I grew from massively, and especially becoming a mum as well, like, just completely changed me.
So you're a gamer?
Massive gamer.
And you like to live stream yourself and yourself playing games. We actually have a bit of a clip here of you doing this.
Yes.
Oh dear.
I'm going to seek for you guys as a little brown potato. Yeah. I'm a little brown singing potato.
That's the clip.
So my question is that song on the new album?
Yeah, that's the hidden track at the end.
But yeah, you live stream yourself playing games. Like, what are you doing there?
So I'm a PS5 gamer and a PC gamer. So, like, as nerdy as it gets, really. The last thing, I haven't streamed for a while, but the last thing I streamed live was a game called Phasmophobia. So any gamers out there who know that, they will know what I'm talking about. But it's a ghost hunting game, basically. A lot of jump scares, a lot of craziness. You just have to hunt ghosts, but I love all sorts of games, yeah.
Tom's nodding like he knows absolutely.
He's like, I can tell, you're like,
I was just still thinking about the potato.
It's actually called the pip-tato. Yeah.
Your little girl, Billie Jean, she's 4 now, is that right?
She just turned 5 last week.
Right. Oh. Yeah. See, in most households around this country, it's parents nagging at kids to get off their screens.
Yeah.
Are the roles reversed in your house?
Well, I've actually... I've trained her, so she knows all the controllers. She knows how to play everything. Like she knows how to. There was a cat game called Stray. I only let her play kid friendly games, but she's already a pro. I limit the time. It's only very small amounts of time, but yeah, she likes gaming too. I'm proud of it.
Well, you can see Ladyhawke live on her Time Flies tour. Ticket details are on our website. The album is out now. Please hold up the album, Lisa.
Part of it.
And please thank Ladyhawke.